So I just bought this attachment. It's kind of cool. I got a symbol. I bought all the attachments, which is this curl one, which comes with this, which you can put the barbell, the easy curl, on. I kind of don't like this. I might take this off unless I bring up my easy curl bar up here. Because it kind of, but this comes with the stand, which I have to assemble, and then it comes with the leg extension and the hamstring curl. So I thought I'd give this one a shot first. But I could just take this off if I didn't want it. Be making it a little bit easier to store, but it doesn't really hurt, especially if I want to do some variation. I'm just not sure how, this looks pretty sturdy. Originally, I was just going to buy just the leg extension attachment for this hoist bench, but I ended up buying everything because I just thought if I'm going to keep this for a long time, then probably better get the attachments now before I forget and it comes out of stock or something. This 35s now. And I'm kind of close to the couch here, so I don't have as much room as I'd like. It's really as heavy as I want to go. And this is the original attachment I got with it, which I assume is just for to put your feet under. But I rarely really even use this. Maybe it could have some other kind of use. I'm not sure, actually. And eventually when I get the stand, I'll probably put it in the corner and put down a plastic mat in the corner for it. That won't take up like a large amount of space. And this thing is kind of cumbersome, but I think the rack makes it kind of smaller, but I'll know when I fully assemble everything. And I drink hot tea when I'm working out, which probably isn't a good idea because Then I get more hot, which is not a good idea. Well, this isn't working out that hard, so more multitasking. Last set I'm gonna do here with this bar. Don't actually know where I'm gonna put it, but maybe in the corner for right now. Well, it works. I feel a good pump, although probably not the best form. It's pretty easy to take out, but this thing's kind of huge here, so let's see, does it fit over here? Kind of, not really. And then I can put this back here. And I hope this is kind of lasts a while. This thing's already kind of... This thing is broken, fuck. So... But it's just the plastic top. Not that bad, I guess. But yeah, this... I think it's mainly just to keep your push against, maybe? I don't know. I should move the bench. Feels good. I'm starting to use more of the power block switching between the 20s and the 12 and a half so that I can jump from 35 to 42 instead of jumping from 35 to 50, which is kind of unrealistic for what I'm trying to do right now. I just gotta make sure I match everything up, which they're color coded, which makes it a little bit easier. The lighter one's red. Everyone's white, which helps when you don't necessarily want to read. I actually feel pretty good pump so far just from this kind of isolation exercises. I haven't done these types of exercises in a while because I hurt my bicep. So it's feeling better finally. So. So if I feel anything start to hurt, I'll stop. My left bicep that's been bothering me. And these pants, I don't know if it's the dumbbells or the pants, but I kind of get caught sometimes on the pockets when it's too baggy. But that's really annoying. And I want to do some grip work today too. I'm just not sure if I should do it now or at the end. So I'm feeling my biceps kind of starting to fatigue a bit. Maybe I'll finish up this exercise more set, and then I could maybe I'll do one more bicep with the forearm, like a hammer curl or something seated. Now I can start using my gripper, which I rarely use anymore, but this thing I've had forever. I gotta start doing my grip, but I hurt my grip pretty easy. I gotta be careful. You see, my left is going out. It's the one I hurt, so I think it's just not as strong. I think I might. I'm getting kind of fatigued, so maybe I'll try some grip stuff and then do one last bicep exercise. Yeah. Yeah, I hurt it. It's like hurting inside. Not right now, but it was. And this thing, this gripper is kind of hard, like I can't get it above, not that high on this thing, so that's like really easy on the lowest setting. So I'm gonna try a little higher here. I'm sweating. The hot tea and the working out makes me overheat. Okay, so. But I don't know if it's because I rarely use this thing. I mean, it pretty much looks the same as when I bought it 10 years ago. I feel bad I never use this thing at all. I should, because my grip is terrible. I think it's an Iron Master or something, or it's a ripoff of an Iron Master or something, I don't know. Thank you. Since I rarely do grip, I'll probably just do one more set. I know it's not really much of a workout, but after this, I'll do some hammer curls. Maybe that'll be a little bit more grip work in if my grip's not chopped. I really like the loose leaf fresh brewed tea. Tastes really good. I guess this doesn't really work out the thumb at all. Try 35 for hammer curls. I'm gonna do it seated again just because I never do seated stuff, so I thought, why not just do everything on the bench today? This is kind of lazy, but that's what I feel like doing. Black 35. Yeah, this is, well, seated, I don't know. Standing, I think I can do like 40 or 50, but let's see, is this too heavy or too hot? And I realize the back isn't straight, so maybe I'll straighten that out. I'm just gonna jump 50. This might be too heavy now that I'm straightening out the. I can't cheat as much. Or maybe I can still cheat, I don't know. Depends. This is a pretty short workout, but I can only gauge it by how much I'm drinking, so it's probably only been like 20 minutes. But I'm not doing a lot of mainly biceps, and then like one or two kind of grip things, exercises. I'm kind of beat up this week too, so that's my excuse. And when I get my leg press extension, I'm going to do one of my old leg workouts that I haven't done in a long time. Just do like a lot of reps with leg extension, hamstring curls, and then squats downstairs, which I need to change. I need to put a full length there so I can see what I'm doing. No, that's too heavy for me, and I'm cheating like crazy, so that's the thing I probably should have. This is what normally happens on the power boxes. If you just stick to the one handle, the jumps on body part stuff that's like bicep or tricep or shoulders, side delt, the jumps are too high. So it's so fine when you're doing chest or back or anything to do those higher jumps, but for this, it's no, too much. Well, I'll just finish off doing this. Two more, I guess. Or one more, I don't know. Call it a day. And it's just too heavy for me to do two arms. I'm kind of cheating. Well, I am cheating. I'm not really using my biceps that much, but whatever, it's the last thing. One more than I'm done. But I'll put all the attachments in the corner. I should have a pretty good workout area just for shoulders and biceps and triceps. And chest. If I can think of kind of more variation than what I normally do, but I gotta be a little bit more creative. I'm only doing like the same three or four exercises every time. And then when I'm done, I always take out the handle thing and put it there. Okay.